Peak District National Park and the RAF Mountain Rescue Association. My job here today is quite simple. I brought a walk-in from Rushworth Edge yesterday, which is finishing here today, and then I'm going to hand over. What I'd just like to say to you is really we're all here today to enjoy ourselves and to help others to enjoy themselves. We of course are here on the site of the Longdendale Trail, which is a part of the Transpennine Trail. Transpennine Trail, it starts at Southport and finishes at Hornsey. It's a project that has been carried out by 26 local authorities with money from the Millennium Commission. So first of all, we're going to hand over the scroll to the next team, and then we're going to open this new wheelchair route, which is an easy access route from here onto the trail. Then we're going to go onto the trail with the wheelchairs, where we're going to have these displays by the Peak Park Rangers and the Education Service from the Peak Park. First of all, I'd like to introduce you to Peter McGowan, the organiser of the whole walk, who will say a few words. Peter.
Okay. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's not often you see a mad joke in this valley. You know, I'm not lost. I'm heading for my homeland up north. Just to put you in a picture of what we're doing here, when somebody suggested we should do something for the Millennium, I suggest that we do a wee walk. Now, when you say a wee walk to any Scotsman, you've got to have you've got to air that with a bit of caution. Because a wee walk could be round the corner to the paper shop, or it could be to the end of the world. Ours is from end to end, from Land's End to Cape Wrath. And it's mainly a celebration of 57 years of the RAF Mountain Rescue Service to the community. Because if you go out onto these hills, Kinder and Bleaklow, elsewhere, Wales, the Lake District of Scotland, the boys in blue over there will always come and have a wee look for you. And generally, we'll find you. So that was it. We're celebrating that. In addition to that, we're hoping to raise some money to buy a Jumbolens. And the Jumbolens, we brought this wee one down here from Glasgow. It's just come down. When you have a chance, go around and have a look at it. We're hoping to buy one of those as a celebration of this millennium. So if anybody in any way can support us on that. Now, this is a bit different to some of the press calls I've had before. We started at Land's End on the 30th of January, so we've been going 63 days now. We've covered something like nearly 900 miles. The ones at Land's End was a protocol. We were in Carnarvon Airport on Thursday the 16th, and again that was a protocol. And we brought all the rescue services in both places. Here we've done the same. Soon, as I say, you've got the RAF Stafford team here, you've got three civilian teams, that's Glossop, Kinder and Hope Valley, in the valley doing a training exercise today. Hopefully about 12:30 they're going to come in to you. But today is mainly for access for all, for people to go up and enjoy what we've got. Now a lot of people have put a lot of effort in today. There's been loads of rehearsals. This is run like a military operation. We've got all these rangers, information staff and education staff up in the trail there in all this fantastic kit. So if you've got the time, go up and appreciate that. We've also got 12 primary schools coming in as a military operation. You imagine the change of the guard. Oh, for God's sake. Well, we've got all the schools to be coming in now in about an hour and a half's time. And they're going to come in here just to support us and do this little walk for us for the Millennium. With a bit of luck, we'll have the yellow helicopter coming in from Leckenfield. It'll be coming in at 11 o'clock. You'll find it flying around the valley, but it's moving between the crags. There's one away up there. It's a white Land Rover sitting on that crag just on the skyline there. And that's the RAF Stafford team. It's coming in there first at 11 o'clock. So where all these activities are going on. And then that'll go to two other sites. But the fourth exercise is straight across in those fields there at 12:30. So there you are, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for coming. I know it's bad to come out on a Saturday. but I'm really impressed. And I'm also impressed that the mayor is here, because we asked him to arrange the weather, and thankfully, look at that, he brought it on song straight away. So I think he deserves a clap for that. Good man.
Well, yesterday I came in with leg 62. We left Rushup Edge at 9:15. We walked over Brown Knoll and Kinder and Bleaklow. We called in at various wrecks and we placed crosses on four wrecks on the way through. And we arrived here at just after 5:00. So that's the end of leg 62. There were four of us on the walk, including the cameraman making it five. So it gives me very great pleasure to hand over this scroll to you to do leg 63 from here at Dorside Visitor Centre. So here we are. Do you realise the team leader carries it all the way?
Yes. Thank you.
All the best.
Well done.
I'm the team leader doing leg 63. I'm from the 8th Air Training Corps at Hyde and Hattersley. We're leaving Torside car park. It will be about 10:40. Heading up.
Don't listen to these guys. Don't listen to them. Don't. Shut up. Behave yourself. We're going to try and behave ourselves we're going to play some tunes. Thank you.
Oh. You kill our animal! Oh, you won't! Oh. You won't!
Our food! It's wild animal that go bar! We hunt it!
Hunt it!
Animals been off the noble!
This is our land! We look after the land! We sow crops! We look after animals!
We make our food!
We hunt! We want. We want our right to roam here. You build your houses?
Benny Vici Vici.
See, I'm just exercising my right to roam about 60 odd years after Benny.
I'm lost.
That's a ranger. Where do you come from?
I've come from Ardertalia in Sestrum. Glossop.
And where are you trying to get to?
Anavio, in the area that you call the Valley of Hope.
Oh, you're a bit of way out of your way, aren't you?
I had some of these awful Frisian sort of militia men with me, and they took me on to the tops, and then they saw some Brigantes tribesmen, and then they ran off and left me.
All on your own?
All on my own.
Oh, oh dear. And all of us?
Yes. Does anybody know the way to Anavio?
Does anybody know the way to Anavio?
No. Just follow the trail.
I think you call it Bradwell.
Oh, right.
Anybody know the way to Bradwell?
I've got an urgent message for the conductores of the lead mines in Castleton.
Oh, what do you have to say to them?
I've got to tell him that we're recalling the governor, Julius Agricola, is recalling the legions back to Sestrum, Chester, to mount a campaign against these awful Picts in Caledonia.
So you mean you will leave us here all on our own and we won't get protected?
Why, who are you?
Well, who are you?
Who are you?
We're from the mill.
Oh.
Yeah. We met these people, and have you ever seen anything like this?
Horseless
like
chariots. Where are the horses?
Well, I don't know.
Well, I could do with one of those. It's
do anybody want to get out and lend him one?
You look fairly high.
Well, if you wanted to say that, you could sort of hijack one, couldn't you?
Well, we could. But I need to go over there.
Oh, well, I'm sure.
What is that? What is that big bird?
I don't know. We don't know what that is.
Oh.
No.
It's a bit frightening.
It is. It's been chasing us.
Oh, blimey.
So if you go in... Look.
I have to go.
Look, what about all these people? They are now our friends. We are trying to do our
Are they friends of Rome?
Are you friends of Rome?
Oh, that is all right.
But I think we need to go back...
Hail Claudius!
Hail Claudius!
No, I'm for Queen Victoria.
Your queen is Carthamandua.
No.
Of the Brigantes.
No, it's Victoria.
And her husband, Venusius.
Albert!
No.
Yes.
No. Are you arguing me?
Oh, not again. We've had this all before. We've been chased by men with spears and furs. We've
and
just...
a big yellow bird.
I think we should turn round and go back.
I will come with you. I will guard you.
Shall we have him come back with us?
In 1854, the reservoirs were being built around the Derbyshire area. At this time, a collection of small shanty towns had grown up, dotting the local countryside. In one of these shacks lived a Mr. and Mrs. Forshaw, their three children and six lodgers. The shack in question was only one story high and built from rough rocks, clay and straw thatch. In this shack, a terrible fire started, in which the two youngest children burned to death.
Get up! Come on, time for breakfast.
Mummy's cool.
Come here. Peter, you kids are more trouble than you're worth. Get that on you.
Is that all the Paris there is?
Yes, that is all the Paris there is. What do you expect? We have six lodges.
Mum, I don't
feed
like
them all.
Porridge anymore.
I don't like porridge more.
I don't care if you don't like porridge.
Right. The shack was divided into two rooms. One housed the family and the other accommodated the six lodgers. The lodgers worked hard for this room, either in the mills or down at the reservoir.
I hate these reservoirs. Always so wet and muddy.
Gonna get pneumonia one of these days.
Tell me about it.
Plus were very noisy and the workers often had to use sign language to communicate as they literally couldn't hear themselves speak. Once Mr. Forshaw, the six lodgers and his eldest son had left for work, Mrs. Forshaw saw the other two children to bed. She then cleared away the breakfast dishes and went out into the garden.
Come on, you two. Come on, you two. Have you come? And how's Maureen? You're helping me in the garden, yeah?
Mrs. Forshaw remained in the garden for about an hour and then got up to leave. It was only then that she had cause for alarm as she turned and saw the house was enveloped in smoke.
Oh my God!
Passerby tried to fight his way into the burning shack, but unfortunately he was beaten back by the flames.
Back to what? I can't get in!
A memorial now stands where the shack once stood, in memory of the two children that perished within its walls.
Thank you. Thank you.
Was it only working on her? So,
somebody actually asked me, she was in Snowdon last week with him. This lady said to me, we're waiting for Harry Wagg coming up, I was doing the horseshoe. And she said to me, you're wearing tights under that? I says, what? She says, can I have a look? I says, anyway, lads, thanks very much for today. It's been a pleasure working with you. Just pulled it off, a major scoop today. This is the third one.
Certainly am. They're getting all their dues.
They weren't paid for 3 weeks, I've heard.
Three whole weeks have not been paid, sir.
Well, they drank enough beer in that 3 weeks.
That's another thing. Why don't they get money? We get paid in coin of the realm at the mill.
Don't you want them sitting, we'll get nothing.
They get paid very well.
Yes, but they've only got these tokens.
Well, they
we can buy beer with them tokens.
You want Harry here, you want Harry
here. What about the food?
They get food tokens as well.
But I've heard that they can only use the food tokens at certain times, but they can use the beer tokens any time.
Hey. Well, what's wrong with that?
Yes, very happy with that, very happy with that.
Give us a sail.
Right, Jones, the steam.
Jones? From the valleys?
Three, baby.
Three.
One.
Is that I'll swap that for two more beer tokens.
One, two,
three. Thank you very much, thank you.
Right.
Hungry for me beer.
Seamus McFlattery. You can get behind the queue.
Which queue?
Three beer tokens, one.
Oh, no, just beer tokens will do.
Beer tokens will do, that's fine. And beer or food?
Beer.
Beer, there you go. That's for you.
Oh, can get drunk tonight, boys.
Oh, I know that.
Seamus
O'Hara, sir.
Oh, hello there.
Beer
tickets. Forget the food.
Forget the food.
They'll have to wait.
Friday.
It's Friday and it's payday.
Right.
How many hours have they had to work for this?
Only 75 this week.
The fine drink, sir.
You're bringing your kids up to work behind bar. Why? Oh, Frosty Jones.
Thank you. माया लो जिमका उपरेली जो डाला।